finishing touch of the commercialization phase is about the adoption rate. We've posted two interesting charts, in our eyes, interesting charts, about Bitcoin legality in the world and Bitcoin adoption, which should be one-on-one, because if it's legal, people might adopt it or not, or if it's forbidden, people won't adopt it. But you will find some interesting things if you compare these charts. So we dare you to find the differences. For example, take a look at Russia, where they have a high adoption rate of Bitcoin, but where it's forbidden to use Bitcoin. So that's a good example of how difficult it is to forbid something or some technologies like these. Other than that, other than the legal challenges that you encounter with adopting blockchain or Bitcoin or digital currencies or whatever, new technologies, is that you have all different kinds of challenges. Only think about this really current example that you are currently experiencing yourself. How do you educate people on these new topics? So how do you bring them up to a level that they can actually use this stuff? Try to let your mother use, for example, your Bitcoin wallet, or try to install even one on her computer, which is difficult, of course. Keep in mind that if we post stuff like the top 10 blockchain adoption challenges, that everything that's in the top 10 is often very biased and very subjected. So once more, do your own research there, because something needed out in 10 equal rows is most likely, not deliberately or undeliberately manipulated into fitting that certain format. Why not top 9 challenges or top 11 challenges, for example? Already mentioned, here you can find some more information about the repeating cycle of a adoption cycle like this, and the hype cycles that happen. Give me a sec. A hype cycle that keeps happening like this, and then it continues here, and then we will start all over again. So as mentioned before, Bitcoin is a good example of this. For the first time, you can actually buy the technology, so you see this in a price movement if you compare it, for example, with dollars. Also note that if you change this currency, for example, if you take the Turkish lira, you will have a different chart, which doesn't mean that the adoption rate or whatever is different, but keep in mind on how do you measure it. And that's the interesting component of Bitcoin. You can measure it against multiple things, of course, like gold as well. Other than that, commercialization phase, I want to finish off strong and with an interesting clip from Simon Sinek, who explains one of the most fundamental parts of, if you want to sell something, start with why. So why should you buy this new innovative product, or radical, whether radical or whether incremental, but start with why. If you explain the why, then look at how, and afterwards with what. So highly recommended, watch the clip. If you want to learn more about commercialization innovations, selling the products, watch that clip. For now, I think this was the final slide regarding the phases. Yeah. That's a wrap. The final phases, commercialization phase, finishes with the video of Simon Sinek. Enjoy, and we will see you into the next phase, where we're going to look on managing and measuring innovation. See you there.